Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Crimes of the Imposter, which I found right here in Fort Pale Pass, Captain's Quarters. The Crimes of the Imposter, two accounts of the known atrocities committed during the Imperial Simulacrum. The Lake Ramar Massacre. Upon the third Sundas of Sun's Height, 3rd Era, 397, the traitorous battle mage Jaegar Tharn, masquerading as our Imperial Sovereign, Uriel Septim VII, ordered the merciless deaths of children of the Dureni West following a minor disagreement. The Duke of Johanna, furious over Imperial involvement in the War of Bendermach, ordered his aides onto his ship, the Inwald Lewis, and set sail for home with his compatriots. With no provocation, the Imperial soldiers of the 8th Legion were ordered to fire on the Breton ship. Arrows raked the deck, leaving many wounded or dead. Only when the last man fell did the volleys stop. Without a pilot, and caught in a gentle wind, the ship began to drift, and had scarcely turned a 25 degrees before a great fireball was cast from the shore by an unknown mage. Hissing low across the surface of the pristine lake and leaving a trail of steam in its wake, the fireball smashed into the Inwold Lewis just above the waterline. The ship sunk almost immediately, taking the Duke and all of his retainers with it. One thinks it is safe to assume that the traitor was the one to destroy the ship, for the 8th Legion was primarily a home force at the time, and had only a very small number of mages enlisted in its ranks. To remember the crimes that were committed there, the true Emperor Uriel Septim VII erected a monument on the southern shores of Lake Ramar. Although today much of the water is dark and murky, on a clear day the wreck can be seen by those who wish to remember the awful crimes that the traitor inflicted upon the Starry Heart. The Intellectual Pogrom. In the chaos that reigned while Jaegar Tharn wore the Dragon Crown, few people noticed when 8 great mages and over 200 intellectuals simply vanished. Since wizards and scholars live by their own agendas and are prone to vanish without warning, few, if any, eyebrows were raised. The truth was not discovered until a mass grave of well-dressed and well-equipped mages and scholars was discovered by a wandering Bosmeri ranger outside of Falaneste's northern apex near the Cyrodiil border. Piecing together scattered evidence, investigators believed that each of the scholars and mages were invited to the grove for various reasons, where they were systematically slain. The most concerning of the bodies was that of a barely charred corpse of a gray cloak of Arteum. Only a mage of great power could have rivaled a Sijic, indicating that Tharn was possibly there himself to dispatch of these innocent men and women. Most of the mages showed signs of a struggle, but the scholars appear to largely have been slaughtered with only meager attempts to resist. What is interesting to note is that the truly greatest mages of Tamriel were not among the victims. Celerus, Fear, and Traven all proclaimed that they never received an invitation. The murders point to a cold and bitter mind, one so concerned with holding his stolen power that he would murder those that enlighten and defend our realm. A memorial stands in northern Valinwood for those that were slain. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim, Crimes of the Imposter.